If you're launching a new online community, taking the time to prepare and plan is crucial to its success. The best way to start is to determine why and where you're building your community. I'm going to talk about how to do that right now. Whether you're an industry expert, an online course creator, or a small business, the benefits of building an online community are undeniable. Among the many benefits, communities can turn your followers into brand ambassadors, drive traffic to your website, help you retain customers, and increase your revenue. In this video, I'm going to show you how and where you can build your online community with examples of how to build these engaged communities around your business and brand. First off, what is an online community? An online community can be defined as a group of individuals unified by a common interest, opinions, and goals who meet in a virtual space. Depending on your business goals, this may look like a private group, Twitter list, or a membership website. Whatever your platform of choice, online communities are a great way to facilitate meaningful connections between your followers. So why build an online community? Online communities can be a great way to bring your audience together in one place where they can discuss your content, apply their learnings, and ask questions. This also helps you get a pulse check on what your audience wants to learn from you. For most brands, an online community is a way to bring your audience and your potential audience together in one place to share ideas, discuss strategies, and get actionable feedback on your products or services. Regardless of the size of your brand, there are many common benefits to creating an online community. You'll be seen as a leader in your space by expanding your sphere of influence by growing your network and audience. You can create brand ambassadors, which can increase the referrals to your business. You'll receive feedback from your audience by having regular dialogue with your community, which helps you improve your products and services to serve them better. You can increase revenue as your community will help foster more engaged followers, increase retention, which can ultimately increase sales. And you can better respond to market shifts as digital communities help you maintain touch points with your audience when being in the same physical space isn't possible. So now, where are you going to build your community? When most people think of online communities, they think of social networks like Facebook or LinkedIn, which allow users to create groups and pages to engage their followers. And that's fine. However, you can leverage social media platforms like Twitter, YouTube, and your own website to build your own online communities. The benefits of using social media platforms are, first, they're free. The other major benefit of building a community on social media is that your community can be discovered by users searching for communities like yours or engaged with similar communities and from sharing content posted on your community. Let's take a look at my own online community on Facebook, the Digital Media Creator Academy. This is a private Facebook group I created to help bring other social media managers, digital marketers, and other creators to learn, educate, and grow through one centered community. I chose Facebook as the platform to build a community on, as it's just the largest social media platform out there right now, and the majority of the people who I engage with were already very active on Facebook. And it seemed like the perfect place to begin building my own online community. Now, you can think of social networks as an extension of your overall community strategy, but they're not the be-all end-all because community elements can be hosted on your website where you're most likely driving your audience to anyway. An often overlooked social media platform to build an online community on is Twitter. And you might be thinking to yourself, Twitter, but how? And that's a great question. You can do two really easy things on Twitter to start building a community there, although they, like many other avenues, will take time to build. One way is to utilize Twitter lists. When you find a great person or brand to follow, you can click on their following list to find others like them already in their Twitter community. Many people also use Twitter lists to organize the people they're following, which you can also view from their profile page. Creating your own list can help you organize your own followers and make it easier for people in your virtual social circle to follow each other. The second way would be to start your own Twitter chat. Now, Twitter chats are real-time conversations around a topic or set of questions that are prepared in advance. Kick off your own Twitter chat by tweeting out a question. Accompany it with a descriptive hashtag so your audience can find the conversation. Raise awareness for your Twitter chat by cross-promoting it in advance through other channels, like your Instagram stories, Facebook page, or your email list. Remember that Twitter chat should be compelling, so include fun, engaging content like GIFs, images, emojis, and videos. Before hosting your own, get involved in other people's Twitter chats to gain insights into what makes a chat successful. If you're building your online community on your own platform, you can customize things like fonts, colors, and key imagery without the noise and distractions that come with social media platforms. Now, whether you're building your community on social media or on your own platform, make sure to update your group description, profile photos, and cover imagery. It's easy to get sidetracked when you're by yourself, so by creating this online community, you're motivating each other to stay on track. Especially in the case of learning communities, such as an online course or a membership site. Members in the community are there to motivate each other and hold each other accountable. The more engaged your community is, the better your results will be. You'll need to set the tone of your community early on and spark opportunities for members to engage within your community. Here are a few best practices to spark engagement within your community. Create a theme for each day of the week. Ask questions. Participate in discussions and respond to those questions. And share content that lives exclusively in your community. Building an online community is hard work, but it's not an impossible feat. There are many free options like Facebook groups to start your online community in. But if you want ownership and control or the ability to add a paywall to your community, your own website is where you want to build. If you're passionate about what you know or want to create a social ecosystem for your most engaged followers, there's no better time than now to start your online community. To learn even more about social media marketing, video, and product reviews, make sure to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.